Yeah, one person has asked about importing awning from Morocco and selling it here. All that is not necessary, sir. We are quite happy with doing what is available in India itself. So,
am I audible, Krishna?
Yes.
Okay, hi. We had spoken earlier on the phone. I was referred by Mr. Anguraj. All right, so my question, you have answered to me already, but I just wanted you to extend this to everyone as well. So you said you have been doing this for quite some time through your company. So why all of a sudden investing, I mean, crowdfunding, and if you can get a loan from a bank, you can do it yourself. Why crowdfunding all of a sudden? You have answered this to me, but I just wanted you to explain this to others as well.
First of all, Ravi, thanks for investing with us. And thanks for asking this question also. Okay, so the thing is, if I just want to be, you know, kind of rich, wealthy and all the stuff, then I don't need to share this information with any of you. Okay, as you said, my cost of funds, if I raise it from a bank, is anything less than 10% only. So that is going to be much, much easier for me. But then the point is, I understand the situation in which this whole community is suffering with this pandemic lockdown. And as I said, in the first place, it was tailor-made for Uday's problems only, actually. Uday want to have some kind of relief with the little bit of investment that you can do. And that's how the whole thing started snowballing, actually, right? So now it's being made into a public venture altogether. So I'm also putting an investment from my side also, even this season. I've been doing it regularly, I'm doing this season also. So there's a limit for everything also, right? So I can sell all my properties and put everything in the awning business. That will be foolish. I wouldn't expect you guys to do that also, okay? So that's also going to be kind of foolish. So the thing is, we need to know how to spread our risk. We need to know how to keep our portfolio diversified. I already run some four different businesses around the world. So this is also another business of mine. And so I think more participants will be helpful, simple as that.
But one more question was, how, it's the first time your company is doing this, right? So how will you show it in your books in your books? So my part, I can take care. So it's a proof of income,
correct.
Yes. From your point, have you taken care of it already or yet to do that process?
This is a trading company which has been dealing with onions already. So we will be buying onion on your behalf and we'll be selling it on your behalf. So we'll have a purchase bill and a sales bill. And so that will cover everything. So the document that you got, MOU, is a generalistic one. And for the specific investment that you make, we'll be giving you bills in your hand once the transaction is done. And what's the third question? From Ravi?
I mean, these were only two questions. I mean, you gave me the answer earlier as well. It was very convincing to me. So I just wanted you to share it with everybody else. So
that's
the reason I had asked this. But thanks.
Thanks a lot.
Hi, Uday and Krishnan. It's Chetan from Hyderabad. I have two questions. Even I'm not much technical on this onion business. Even I know Uday from last 3 years. Just first question is, because can you please explain the onion business, how it was from last 3 to 4 years? And the second question, if suppose I have invested something like the minimum investment, you said like 1 lakh. Okay, fine. I'm going to invest 2 lakhs at this point of time, just as example. And maybe my family...
You said 2 lakhs, I was happy for a minute. And then you said just for example...
Sure. Even we can continue with that. Okay. And something,
okay.
Even maybe at least in a month of August or September, we are going to get the returns. Something I required, maybe 50,000 rupees or 20,000 rupees, whatever, some amount if I required. Can I take it back?
See, generally, we don't suggest that you take back because the whole idea is for you to benefit out of the investment. So, if we do get a good price in the month of August, at the end of August, then definitely, yes, you can opt out, you can take it out partly. Okay. But generally, we would advise to hold on and get the best returns possible. But we are not going to return back your money before August, whatever be it. Like you must say that there must be some medical emergency or this thing or that thing. We cannot help you in those kind of circumstances. So make sure that you have adequate funds for your family and yourself and for your medical emergencies. Then if you have something left over, that only please invest with us. Because we don't want you to bother us and we don't want to feel guilty that we cannot help you in the right moment of time for your medical emergencies. Okay. So there is definitely a lock-in period.
Okay. Thank you. And can you explain me, because I joined a bit late on the session. Maybe you have covered this point. Can you just give me the brief of how the onion business from the last 3 years?
Sir, actually, you need to, sorry to say that we cannot do this in this session because you need to go refer the video again. Please go through the video again and call me personally. My number is, I'm going to text it now for you. It's already there in the video. I'm going to get, for the benefit of all, I'm going to text you now. So please call me personally. I'll explain to you in detail. Yes,
Anguraj.
Very good morning. How are you?
Good.
Big round of applause for Anguraj. He's been very instrumental in getting a lot of his friends to invest in this. So my heartfelt thanks to you, Anguraj.
Good morning, Anguraj.
Good morning, Uday. Good morning, Uday.
Suddenly, I'm seeing you now only. So long, I didn't see your name.
No, he was there all the time. I saw him as a silent spectator. Now he's opening up his mouth. Okay, that's the case with most investors. That's the case with most investors. You know, they have that urge to invest. But then they don't know how to, you know, kind of spill it out. They don't know what questions to ask. They don't know how to get it clarified. So I'm just waiting for this to happen. Okay. Anguraj, now it's your turn. Please carry on.
My question is, last year, what was your investment and what was your profit? Is it possible for you to share?
Yeah. I think we have already shared this earlier. So since you're asking again in the public domain, I'll do that again. I don't know whether you asked or somebody else asked. I think probably.
Yeah, I asked you. Personally, we spoke about this. See, the persons or the investors which I referred to you to invest in this should have clarity. So, because I'm also new to you, I know Uday past 2 years. So, everyone should know what has past has done for you or in this business.
So, I would also be happy if you're comfortable in sharing how much you have invested this particular season, Anguraj.
See, myself, I invested 1.5 lakh.
Okay, and you're also willing to invest more, also, I guess, so, based on what
We were talking about this yesterday. I am trying to arrange another 5 lakhs payment. Hopefully, before this month end, it will happen.
Okay, right. So, anyway, to answer your question, last year my investment was around 10 lakhs and I took home about 11 lakhs actually as a profit. This year, however, I'm not going to invest 10 lakhs. I'm going to invest only 8 lakhs actually. And let's see as to what the profits are all about.
Okay, like 2019, any idea?
That would be a little bit out of, because the thing is that time I didn't really make use of this opportunity because I was, as you guys, most of you know, I keep traveling to 3 countries every month actually. So it's not just a matter of, you know, investing. It's just a matter of also how you can take care of your property and how you can do it. You know? So that time I was a little bit busy running around between Dubai, Malaysia and Vietnam. So I didn't invest in 2019.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And luckily I didn't invest in 2016 either. Which was a loss-making year. Okay, fine. So next question.
Rakesh here from Singapore. I'm a close friend of Anguraj, so I got a note from you about from Anguraj. So the question what I'm having is, who and how or when you decide the price of the onions when you buy and when you sell? So how do you decide that and who decides this? That's my first question. And the second question is, after you invest, market decides. So even the selling price and the whatever you buy, whenever you procure the ornaments and whenever you sell it. So the rate, fluctuation in the rate, is there any way after we invest in the coming months, after a month or so, or if after a few months, how do we know that this is the current onion rate? How do we know that? And how we know that this is our money progressing? Is there any mode or platform that we can come and check?
Maybe I think you joined late, I guess so. We have already answered this question. So you can be getting daily updates from us once the market opens, which is probably from tomorrow, the markets in Nasdaq will open. And there's one guy sitting silent here, I told you already. There's one guy by the name Chakravarti. He's from South India and he's been getting my daily updates. He's not an investor, but we are the same business. So, you know, we kind of share the daily market rates regularly. And so that's how we're going to share the prices also on a daily basis on your WhatsApp as a broadcast list. And also for those who invested earlier, I have sent a message specifically saying that we are going to share your market rates on a daily basis. Let me know if you're interested to be in this broadcast list by typing yes, or if you don't want to be disturbed, then you can put a no and type back to us. We'll not disturb you with the market prices. I told them. Yes, Anguraj, did you receive that message?
Yes, I have given you yes.
Yeah, okay, fine. So that's how it's going to be progressively from our side. Second thing is, I also shared the chat box the links by which you can also go directly and visit the government websites from which you can get the rates of all the APMCs in India. So you can go and get the rates that way. So that is on the prices, on the daily prices.
Okay, thanks.
Next. All done? Finished? Anything more?
I think most of the questions are answered. If that is the case, I think we can.
I think most of the questions have been answered, and even the list of participants has been steadily coming down. Now it's come down to 29, so it means we have come to the expiry of it actually.
So before Krish gives the last word and concludes the meeting, and if anyone is having any more questions, please shoot out. I would like to thank each and every one of you all who have taken this time and opportunity to come join us on a Sunday morning. Especially, you should be running for onions, because Chennai especially, they said, you know, lockdown starts from tomorrow onwards, 24 hours lockdown for the next 1 week, which means you have to fill up your house with all stocks. But thank you very much for keeping this Sunday morning free, coming over, which means you are serious about this business. Don't hesitate. You trust me, trust Krish, trust the business. And of course, in a pandemic like this, where the first wave is already hit, and my industry, the service industry, is totally like washed out, the second wave has become a tsunami. What was 50% shutdown, the first wave has become 80% shutdown. The only thing that's running right now is delivery, not even tea shops. Many people during the between the first wave to the second wave went into the tea shop business. And the sad part is all tea shops also closed. So, this is a very good time for all of you all to think and get into this business. It is for your own good, your own family. So please take a wise decision. Whatever the amount you want to see out as a return, keep that as the figure and invest, you know, 50% or one third of that amount at least to get good returns. This is my suggestion. This is also a forum where we want to, many people are trusting, like there are somebody who knows me directly, they are just blindly putting money. Someone who knows somebody is coming in and they're putting in money. We want to grow. We're growing as a family. Definitely, we're looking at growing your money for you. So thank you very much for coming this Sunday morning, Krish. You. Anybody else wants to say
anything? Uday and all of you, can you guess the today's price of small onion?
65 rupees per kilo.
Today I bought 2 kgs for 300 rupees. Per kg, 150 rupees.
No, see, that's
oh my
the problem.
God. What is this?
Yesterday also, Angiraj said he bought big onions for 80 rupees per kilo. I asked him, did you buy 3 kilos or what? He said, no, 1 kilo. I was a little bit sharp. So to kind of put this in control only, I'm
going to with the... Krish, that was some confusion. It was should be about 50 or 60. But today, I checked it in each and almost four to five shops. They were mentioning 150 rupees for small onion. And can you guess the beans price? Anyone?
No idea. I was busy with...
this is all... Demand and supply, basic.
300 rupees retail. Per kg. 300 rupees per kg.
No, the question is, Anguraj, did you buy or did you walk away from the shop?
No. I didn't buy the beans. I bought only the small onion and a tomato for 50 rupees.
Why did you do that? Because it is a basic necessity. The point what I'm trying to say is, why are we stressing the importance of this onion business during this lockdown is, it's not like we are going to rush to buy a property or a gold or some kind of a luxury car during these lockdown times. The basic necessity for any human being is food. Maybe today you didn't buy the beans, but tomorrow you'll buy it, you know, because you can't keep eating onion and tomato every day. The point is, these kind of daily necessities will always have a demand and it will always keep us kicking. It's going to be a 365 days business. So that's exactly the reason why we're saying again and again, during this lockdown time, make use of this golden opportunity, invest in this business and enjoy the benefits of it. So you enjoy the fruits of the business by investing in onion being a vegetable. Yeah.
In the pandemic, we can understand only two industries, the medical industry and the agriculture.
True. Let's conclude now. Thanks a lot, guys. So big thank you all to each and every one of you over here. And this video was also recorded. So I'm going to put this also on the YouTube channel. So if you have missed it out, you have missed the earlier session, came late, or maybe you came early and left late, you can always go back and watch this video on YouTube. And I'll also share the link down the line. So thanks once again for joining us this morning. Have a nice day. Stay blessed. Thank you.
Thank you, Krishna. Thank you. Thank you,
Uday. Thank you, Krishna. Thank you, Mr. Uday. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.